The topic for the day is to create the components that are accessible, the components making them even richer, considering people with disabilities in mind. Who am I? I am RP, and I have RP. I'm a person with retinitis pigmentosa, and I'm Rakesh Paladugula. RP is a genetical disorder which diminishes or deteriorates the vision over a period of time. My day job is a training manager for accessibility at Adobe, and I'm a blogger at Maxability, www.maxability.co.in. So how is it at the beginning? All is well. I am like Amir Khan in Three Idiots. I am not a great student, but yes, to pass my subjects. As I was diagnosed with the problem of RP, the vision started deteriorating. So what's the problem? It is difficulty in studying my school books. Can anyone of you read this word for me? Pneumonia ultra, sorry, even I cannot pronounce it so quickly. So it is a 45 character word, pneumonia ultramatric silico volcanoconiosis, which is perhaps the longest word in English dictionary. And many of you took few seconds to read this word. My experience was similar in the beginning, reading few character words, like a 4 or 5 character word. It used to take some time. I'm obviously a slow reader. To add to this, the other problems that have come together is reading lengthy lines, need more contrast or more light when I was reading my school books, etc. So not only for me as a person with low vision at that point in time, but also people who have cognitive challenges also usually have the problem of slow reading, understanding the content a little late, so which we call it as dyslexia or learning disorder. So as one of the in one of the interviews, Steven Spielberg says that it takes to read a 120 page book, for him it takes 2 hours 45 minutes, whereas any general user takes 1 hour 10 minutes, which obviously says that he is a slow reader. Understanding takes time, and most of the people who have dyslexia have the challenge of understanding the content a little late. So the next comes in is the Facebook, our favorite social media app, is more in blue color. The reason is simple, is that to ensure that the red-green colorblind people who cannot differentiate between the red and green colors depend on alternative methods or need more better color for their vision to read it. And it is obvious, if you have ever noticed, that 1 in 12 men have color blindness, and most prominently it is red-green color blindness. So if I say people around 8% of the world's population have color blindness and red-green colorblindness specifically, do you mean that you need to have only blue color websites? Not necessarily. All that we are bothered about is to make enough contrasting between the colors, use colors wisely, and ensure that there is no information that is conveyed solely depending on colors. Usually we do this of user experience of making all the mandatory controls on a form in red color. So which will have a difficulty for people who have color blindness. In addition, if we add a star or an asterisk or any other programmatic way of identifying that those controls are mandatory, it is helpful. So all that we need to say is have a better contrast, and also contrast between the foreground and background colors. In addition to that, ensure when you are using colors, use them cautiously. So there is this website where you can check what is color contrast and how you can provide a better contrast as per the accessibility standards. So this standard is called Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, which are defined by W3C, recommends that there should be a minimum contrast of 4:5:1 between the foreground text color and its background, so that it will be easy for someone who have color deficiencies to read the content more accurately and easily. So the web aim, the URL here, shows how to test that. Let me walk you through this. So here is the website. So where you can give the foreground color. So I just gave a red, a combination of red color 00FF00 and a background color, some sort of gray, green. And it will show you a contrast ratio. Currently it is 3.09:1 is what the color contrast that is defined by the color contrast analyzer. All that you need to have is the color codes, color values, or the color themselves. You can even pick the color from the palettes and provide the foreground and background color, so that the accessibility tool, the color contrast tool, will provide you the contrast. And you can also change the color values, the lightening or the darkening of the color, so that to check whether it meets the required contrast ratio of 4:5:1. So here, when we are changing the colors, as we change the colors, it has passed at 4:5:1. Okay, then you can pick those colors and add to your color palettes, which will provide you the better contrast. So this, the math of this 4:5:1 is called luminosity contrast ratio, which is a math that is developed or that is created long back with taking different vision challenges into consideration. If you ask me, is this the right color or everyone in the world can see with this contrast? Perhaps not, but this is the best one that anyone can or most of the people can get rid of the contrast in between the colors. So then comes the other problem about the keyboard access. How many of you ever tried just doing some activity on your computer without using the mouse or the mouse pad? Please don't raise your hand. Say yes if you ever have ever tried doing some action like booking a travel ticket just using a keyboard. Yeah, there are a few. How was the experience? Not always. Yeah, someone of you said it's not working. This is one popular travel website. Maybe you can give it a try once you're back and tweet back with your experience, hashtag A11Y, which is accessibility, or you can tweet at me to note your experience, how accessible is it. It's not just this, anything that you just give it a try, doing some activity as simple as posting something on your Facebook or a Twitter handle and just share your experience. This is just to give it a try, but there are people who have challenges because of which they cannot use mouse. Say like muscular dystrophy or anything that hinders using a mouse, have to depend on keyboard alone day in and day out. Think about those users. Are you giving enough experience for them to do the activity that you intend to do? Who creates the problems? So we are talking about the color contrasts, we are talking about the text, and we did talk about the keyboard access. Who are the people who are creating the problems? It is not the people with disabilities who create problems for themselves. The environment that we live in, and we are the ones who create problems for them. Out of ignorance, of course, that we never think that people with disabilities are also the users of the web or the digital assets. Here are the three key stakeholders, the content writers, who never think about people with disabilities and provide instructions such as click the button on the right-hand side, or all fields marked in red are mandatory. which are dependent on people's sensory characteristics, such as shape, size, visual location, orientation, sound, or color, which create problems to the users. Of course, the designers, as we talk about the color contrast, providing specific cues which are dependent on colors alone, also are responsible for creating designs that are usable by everyone. Many of the engineers, like all of us, out of ignorance, we never think about the experiences of people with disabilities, and we don't do the programmatic way of ensuring that the applications are available for all the users, all the end users. So it is a collaborative effort of making accessibility inaccessible. It is not one's responsibility. So, end of the day, what is accessibility? Accessibility is nothing but just making our products, websites, designs, or whatever that we create accessible or usable by persons with disabilities. If we take it more specifically, it is to ensure that people with disabilities can perceive, navigate, understand, and interact with the web. So, how do you define that my application is accessible? We are standard compliant. How do you say that? So this is defined by W3C, the World Wide Web Consortium, which defined a set of standards called Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or shortly called as WCAG. The latest version that is recommended by W3C is WCAG 2.1, and the recommendation is to have compliance at level A and AA standards. So that is the W3C recommended, but most of the organizations and countries just lean on to the recent past recommended standard, that is WCAG 2.0, level A and AA. So here are some links where you can just browse through the standards and how you create a better experiences keeping accessibility standards in mind. What should I do as an engineer? Trust me, you don't need to do anything as long as you do the things right. Right things in right place. Everything is taken care by the technologies that we use. The basic minimum that we do is the HTML and CSS. And if you are using these controls, elements, attributes, and properties in the right way, how it is intended by the W3C or the specifying bodies, that means that you are making the products and websites accessible. If I take this example of a button, here is an example of a button that says button submit with an on-click event up there. All that I have is a button tag with a submit label in between and an on-click event on it. So when I use this HTML button tag, the role is already there. It is a button. Role is nothing but if it's a link, it is a button, if it's a heading, if it's an image or whatever that it is, we call it as a role. Because you are using the native button tag, it says the role is up there. Label is submit. We all defined there. Keyboard navigation comes for free, as if you just put a less button tag and press tab to see it. Yes, the keyboard focus goes there. And if you press enter, as you intend to do it with the on-click event or whatever the action that your intention is, enter or return key will do the action. You no need to bother about it. The focus indicator, the dotted borders that displays around the button will automatically pop up there from the CSS, which is supplied by the browsers. Of course, you can do any additional changes that you want to do, but if you're just providing a normal button, as long as you don't remove the outline Sudoku property from the CSS, the button will act as a button. The focus indicator comes in, the tab order comes in, you don't need to bother anything about it. But when you create a custom button, like the one shown up there, what you did here is that you had a div tag and you have provided an on-click event and you have had a class from where the image like a button is loading up, and you don't have a submit label because you think that the image will be sufficient enough to say that this is a button. What happens to a keyboard-only user? A person who cannot use a mouse? Because this is a div, Div is not a control that you can tab through. Keyboard only user is unable to use it. Because div is a non-semantic control, non-semantic element, the screen readers will not announce it as a button, or the role fundamentally is not available there. Obviously, because you don't, the image is loading from the CSS, there is no way for you to provide an alternative text which can convey as a label for certain users. There is no keyboard focus. Obviously, there is no focus indicator. The border lines are not up there. So you are messing up every possible thing, and you are not allowing any person with a disability to use your button because you are using a custom button. But is Rakesh saying never use a custom button? I am not saying that. Now let us repair it. So the repairing can be done with the technology that is developed by W3C called Accessible Rich Internet Applications, ARIA. ARIA is the specification by W3C to ensure that you create custom components that are usable by wide variety of users. So here is a table that just shows you what is the equivalent of HTML in ARIA. If you are using these attributes and controls, you can make some sense of accessibility, and we'll talk about it in detail. So because you have used a div and you don't have a button role there, instead of less button tag in the div, if you can add role equal to button, it will say that I am a button. And because you haven't provided the label for the image or alternative text for the image, because that comes from the CSS, you can add ARIA-label, which will be acting as a label for some of the assistive technologies. So these are the two properties that you can use in addition to the controls that you already have for a custom button. But of course, ARIA itself cannot provide all the attributes that are required, like the tab focus. ARIA cannot give a tab focus so that the keyboard only user can still don't use, though you provide role and ARIA label. In that case, just ensure that you have the tab index that is supplied by HTML again, because if you are using normal button, no need of tab index, but because it is a div here, you have to provide a tab index. And be careful while you are using tab index. The negative tab index or a positive tab index may create unnecessary problems or newer problems to the users. So in this case, to have a normal focus order, I provide tab index equal to 0, which will not hinder the tab focus order anyways, but still can get the tab focus when the keyboard only user navigates to it. Tab index equal to 0. And then the CSS. Because you don't have a CSS set there, you have to add this the CSS properties, the outline properties to this button as well, so that when a person who uses only a keyboard switches onto that button, it will also show a focus indicator when you provide specifically a focus indicator to this button. So finally, when you have to make it like a button, as simple as a HTML button, add role equal to button, ARIA-label equal to the label of the button, tab index equal to 0, and the classes where you can provide the dotted focuses, dotted line around the button. This is all, as an engineer, you have to take care of. So that is how you are repairing an inaccessible button to a accessible button. So let us little more understand what ARIA is. Accessible Rich Internet Application, as I said, is what the shortly ARIA is what is called as. It's a W3C technology. It specifically helps people who have assistive technologies like the screen reading technologies, which a person with blindness uses. For them, it will provide additional labeling without disturbing the existing UI. So in the example that we talked about, when I use role equal to button, in the UI you cannot see anything that is changed, but it will convey the semantics to the assistive technology users, like a screen reader user. And it is also a specification to say how do you define keyboard interaction for custom controls, and that is defined in ARIA. So the end users who are going to benefit with ARIA are the assistive technology users and the keyboard only users. So of course, every technology comes with set of rules and principles. What are the three key things that you have to keep in mind is that the rule one is don't use ARIA. ARIA's first rule is don't use ARIA, which means, as I said before, if you are using the native HTML content or native HTML things, it is not necessary that you have to have ARIA. As the first example of button, HTML button, you haven't used any ARIA. So as long as you can achieve something with the native semantics, use the native semantics instead of ARIA. So that's the reason we say don't use ARIA as the first rule. The second rule is a promise. We are saying that I am adding a role to this, and I will be ensuring that whatever the properties that the end user needs will be supplied by me. The example which we saw, role equal to button, is what I provided, and I am promising that this is a button. So I have to give the interaction of a keyboard as to tab. I have to give an interaction that the UI of a focus indicator through CSS. All these, as an engineer, I am promising that this is a role of a button, and I will be taking care of the additional properties because I have used this role. Rule 3, ARIA can either clock or enhance the experience of the users. As we said, ARIA can additionally give an additional experience, good experience to the users with screen readers and assistive technologies. But if you are not using as per the specifications, it is also possible that it will clock the experience of people with disabilities. So use it wisely, use as per the specifications. So let us simply see a small example of a model here. As of you know, a model window or a dialog is a piece of window or a window that is overlaid on top of a web page or top of another window. So when you see the interaction of a model, these are the things that you need to keep in mind. Tip one, it need to be keyboard accessible, because when the model is opened, the background page is inerted or dimmed. Only the focus will be within the model. So what all things you need to take care of? On opening the model, the focus should shift to the model. The focus should only trigger within or navigate, travels within the model unless and until it is closed. Focus should be available for all interactive controls on the model if there are any. Focus should be tripped back to the triggering element when the user closes or cancels or submits, or at the minimum should go to the most logical control when the model is closed. These are the keyboard and focus management systems that you need to take care of when you are creating a model. This is about a keyboard. The next one is the name, role, value, states, and other properties. So when you are creating the model, the initiating element will be a normal button. But how does the user know that this button is doing an action that is like opening a model or a dialogue, or it is just submitting something? How does the user know? So you may have to provide additional properties or the labels to the model with the initiating element, etc. So the first thing that we need to provide is a title for the model. Define the roles. We can provide the title as models will have a normal title with ARIA hyphen labeled by or ARIA hyphen label. We can additionally provide a semantic relationship between the title that can be read out by the assistive technologies. Define the roles. So role equal to dialogue is what you have to mention to let the users know that this is a model. If you are using normal HTML things, most of the properties come for free. All the informative controls should have labels. Add value, state, or property depending on the necessity of the model. Like if there is anything like a expand or collapse within the model, you have to provide a state, ARIA hyphen expand equal to true or false, depending on the state in which it is. Or for the button that invokes the model, you make and provide ARIA has pop up equal to true. So these are the ARIA elements that I have used in the model. Role equal to dialog, ARIA hyphen model equal to true. If you are using ARIA hyphen model equal to true, the focus will, the screen reader focus or the assistive technology focus will not go to the inserted page, the background page. ARIA labeled by or ARIA described, ARIA title, ARIA label to read the title when the model is opened. ARIA described by if you want to give an additional information of the model. So these are all something which we have defined. It is all the working group of ARIA, working group at W3C have defined. You can have a look at the W3C specifications and the ARIA authoring practices or the design patterns that are defined in the URL specified here. The next one is colors, which we already discussed briefly. So ensure that the model, the controls on the model, the text, everything had have the required color contrast. There is nothing that depends on color, or it's all something the designer has to take care of. I will just quickly show you a model how an accessible model will activate or work when you are using when you created an accessible model with the assistive technology switch on. Just hang on for 2 seconds.
Modal dialog example Mozilla Firefox. Main landmark apply now button sub menu. Sign up dialog enter your contact information. First name, edit required has autocomplete, blank. Last name, edit required has autocomplete, blank. Email address, edit required has autocomplete. Submit button. Cancel button. Close button. First name, edit required has autocomplete. Last name, edit required has autocomplete. Email address, edit required has autocomplete. Submit button. Cancel button. Banner landmark heading level 1 modal dialog. Main landmark apply now button sub menu. Slideshow slide 27.
So that is how the focus indicators work and how the model is focused. When the user closes it, how it comes back. And if you have heard how the screen reader is reading each control with their corresponding labels. And that will shortly end my talk. And any questions, you can we can talk. Maybe we can take a couple of questions if we have time. Otherwise, we will meet out there on the BVO, what is that called? Bird of Feathers. We have the discussion soon. And you can reach out to me anytime, as long as it is related to accessibility. Rakesh underscore A11Y, I think you might have seen my Twitter handle, or www.maxability.co.in is my blog, where you can definitely look for more information on the accessibility content. Thank you.
Hi, how do you like decide like when you're giving an ARIA label? So for example, if you have a table and you can sort the columns, so in terms of the verbosity of that message, like is it too verbose for a like user who's using the screen reader? So yeah, essentially, what are the recommendations for defining those ARIA labels?
So if I understand your question right, you're talking about a sortable table.
Right.
So ARIA hyphen label is just one property we could discuss in the short time we have, but there is a design pattern that comes for a sortable table. And there is a concept called ARIA hyphen sortable property. And if you are adding this ARIA hyphen sortable property to the column or the cell in which you can do the sortability, and as user navigates to that button and press space bar, it will say has sortable property currently set to ascending. And if you press again, it will switch back and say descending. So whatever the information that is required for the user, that the ARIA-sortable property with conjunction with other specific properties for the table sortable grid or sortable table property, it will provide that information.
Okay, thanks.
Welcome.